Hey everybody, welcome to Obscurities in Miniatures, and it's Friday, which means I will be bringing to you yet another Obscurity in Literature. And today is, well, at least in the English-speaking world, a bit of an obscurity. For the Francophones out there, probably not so much, but today we bring the self-titled Olivier Ledroit book, and this thing is an absolutely phenomenal piece of work. This covers most of the artist's work, at least up to about Wika. I believe it's in there. I haven't looked at the end of the book in a while. I was flipping through the beginning, just waxing nostalgic over it. And legend has it that I had wanted this for my birthday for years. Whatever holiday, any excuse people were giving gifts, this book was number one on the list. And then legend has it that one year my parents ended up in France, and they actually found it in a bookstore and had to lug it home with them. Unless, you know, you can eyeball the size gauge there on the mat, you may not have a good idea of just how big this book is. So grabbing, like, a regular American-sized comic book, probably one of the very few Avengers comics I still own, Avengers Forever, with a great Kang story. This is a regular-sized comic book, okay? Wider comic book. Another classic. We'll talk about Sam and Max some other day. You can see, it's just a big freaking book. Bigger than my deluxe edition Martial Law. We'll talk about Martial Law some other time. But yeah. Olivier Ledroit, been quite busy for quite a few decades at this point. but if you're a fan of fantasy art predominantly, I really do not think you can go wrong. I know there's a lot of illustrations of his that he got started with Heroes of Might and Magic, and I have to be very careful with this because there is all sorts of casual nudity throughout the entire book, and I have to really watch it, not only for that, but because it's so freaking huge that it's going to mess up everything else on my table. So I got to be really careful here. And I cleaned it off, too. That's a sad thing. Now, nicely enough, even though this is a French book, it is in English and in French. So if you can't read French, fear not. Then again, it's not like there's tons and tons of text. It is an art book after all. A lot of ink drawings. We get right into the Dark Moon Chronicles, the Chronique de la Lune Noire, with all of the main cast right here. I've got a few books of his when he was illustrating it. It's a pretty long-running series, and there were actually quite a few figures made based on his designs by Ilyad Miniatures. You want to talk about obscurities. And those figures are not cheap by any means or on any continent. So just to give you guys a nice look-see at just the intricacy of the art, there's a big, flashy two-page spread I'm looking for. I know that's the cover of one of the books because I have it upstairs. Let's see if I can keep the camera balanced. Skip over some of the pages with demons copulating because I'm sure that's going to get me into trouble with the censors. And yeah, oh, actually, I want to say, these are some of his sketches. For it just says unpublished sketches right here, but you can absolutely see some of the stuff. Coincidentally, if I can find the page, is going to end up on the tabletop. As you can see, everything else, that glare. I apologize. Let's see if I turn this light off, if that does anything. Well, it helps a little bit, I guess. Yeah, lots and lots of these two-page spreads, and this is his early work. It only got better from here. Later on, his panels, panel by panel, tends to look almost like this, just with the amount of incredible detail jammed in there. Here's what I was talking about. 67 models were produced by Ilyad, all of them based on Ledroit's drawings. Some of this should look familiar to people who have been into the tabletop stuff for some time. they are not cheap or easy to acquire these days. Let's skip ahead a little bit. Very Chaos Warrior looking. I dig his angels. Usually I'm not into angels either. Now the nice thing about this book is there's a lot of stuff that actually is not the usual. Princess in Amber. That name sounds familiar. Why does it sound familiar? We start to move into his more painted work. Nice looking elf warrior. Vampire sketches. Sorry, not vampires. Dark elves. My mistake. Very elaborate looking stuff. I have no idea what these were used for. Ah, okay. I'm pretty sure this is actually Heroes of Might and Magic artwork. This is a lot of stuff that was actually unused for the game just because the designs were a bit too busy and complex for the animators. At least according to the little blurb. And then we get into the fairies. So, Ledroit is really into fairies, and you'll see a lot of fairies. There's actually an art book of nothing but fairies that he's done, but designs are quite unique. A nice take on traditional fairytime, and actually a lot of it really reminds me of Amano artwork, if you're familiar with Yoshitaka Amano. Very pale, very elaborate inking. Again, a lot of copious nudity, so I have got to be quite careful turning these pages. Yeah, this is a 4-page spread. And these panels end up looking pretty much like this as time progresses. It's pretty wild stuff. It's an absinthe. We get into some of his short stories, and then we start to move into his other comics where he starts to paint them. Character sketches. I don't remember which comic this is from. I love when books show a lot of that early sketchwork and just, again, the amount of detail that is going into these panels is quite impressive. Almost reminds me of like Bernie Wrightson artwork in terms of just all of that cross-hatching and the use of blacks and lines. Very noirish. I don't remember this book. Maybe it's because I haven't read this. This looks like Shaw. Shaw I read, and I know that was in Heavy Metal. That's Sandman. Maybe he was drawing? There we go. There's Shaw. Shaw, you can probably find a copy of Heavy Metals. I don't recommend it, just because the binding is awful, and it stinks. Like, literally, figuratively, it smells bad. I don't know what it is about. Some of those Heavy Metal albums just have an awful, awful odor to them. I don't know why. Let's see, here's some of his design work. Very inquisitorial. Funny enough, I can't think of many actual 40K designs that Ledroit has drawn. If any. Plenty of futuristic stuff. Plenty of monsters and demons. Yeah, I'm just flipping pages at this point because we're getting close to Requiem, I believe, in the book. He did do a couple of sci-fi stories in Heavy Metal, and probably in other places in France, obviously. I am not sure what this is from.
I'm digging the map, though.
I'm curious to see what he would do if given a... some 40k designs. A short story, which we won't spoil. Plus the heroine is not wearing anything in it. And then we get to one of my absolute favorite comics, Requiem. Requiem is not for the squeamish. It is a Pat Mills written book, so bear that in mind. It is quite gratuitous in everything that it does. And over the top. And I personally would love to see somebody republish it in English again. We never got the final volume in a actual physical book outside of the issue of Heavy Metal that it was published in. It is basically a War of the Realms in the Afterlife. And it is pretty wild. And both artist and writer take every excess they can come up with and absolutely dial it up to 11. Good old Claudia. Those are the pages that actually show up in the books. Fighting the pirates, old Dracula, Dracula's court, the various pirate fleets that they fight, lots of airships. Airships always seem to show up in his artwork. All sorts of random characters, like with babies in a dress. Where are the dragons? I think here by Requiem is when we really start to see just the over-the-topness of Ledroit's panel work. And even more so in his newer Wika. It looks like the Royal Dragon Fleet, because I want to say it was Queen Victoria came back as a dragon? I can't remember, it's been a while since I read the later issues. But these are just like typical panels in the comic. A lot of these are actual pages, just minus the dialogue boxes. It's a pretty wild ride. It is in English too, so if you're curious about it, take a look. Again, I would strongly recommend not with children around. It is not children friendly. No, we're not going to pull that one open all the way. We'll let you see what that one's like when you get it yourself. Oh, Andre, you are not going to... Hopefully, YouTube doesn't flag this, but yeah. Some crazy stuff. And you can tell the binding is not doing too well there. I gotta be careful with this book, but I wanted to share it nonetheless! It is a big one. And hopefully, I will be sharing some other Ledroit comics on here in the near future, because I've got quite a few and I really enjoy them. And if you're curious, I do know that his Wicca has been translated completely into English in one big hardcover, so if you want to take a look at that, I'm going to be focusing on that in the next few weeks probably. So I'll put a link for that on Amazon, because this book, well, it comes and it goes, and his Wicca is just as nice and is actually in print. So that can be found, whereas this is going to be kind of a dice roll. So we'll put a link for this too, though, just in case. But I don't want people spending $300 on it. Please don't. It's not. It's cool, and it's worth it, but it's not that worth it. So with that said, this has been High Lord Tamberlane with Obscurities and Miniatures, saying thanks for watching, and we will see you back here soon. Bye-bye.